In previous video, that means in part 5, we have seen digestion of food. The digestion of food, how it is happening in small intestine. With the help of enzymes, the digestion of food will be happening. Okay, so what are the enzymes? I have explained in the previous video what are all the enzymes involved in the digestion of food. Okay, from the liver, from the salivary gland, from the pancreas, many enzymes are secreted. That enzymes involved in the digestion. What are all the enzymes you know? Once again, I want to recall the salivary gland which secrete salivary amylase, then lysozyme also which is secreted, then bile juice will be secreted by liver, it is stored in the gallbladder. Actually, in the bile juice we have some pigments, bile salts and phospholipids, cholesterol, like that. It is doing the function of emulsification of fat. And another one, pancreas. Pancreas which is secrete pancreatic juice which consists some enzymes, that is trypsinogen, then chymotrypsinogen, then procarboxypeptidases, lipases, amylases, nucleases. So these are all the enzymes which is secreted by pancreas. Then small intestine, that small intestine secrete intestinal juice. There we have some enzymes, that is dipeptidases, disaccharidases, then lipases, then nucleotidases. Okay, so these are all the enzymes, nucleotidases and nucleosidases will be secreted in small intestine. So that convert nutrients into simple molecules. So the complex molecules convert into simple molecules, you know, I think. What are the nutrients present in food materials, you know? We have carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins and minerals. Vitamins and minerals in our body we require little amount. That means small amount of vitamins and minerals is enough. So it is directly absorbed by our body. But the carbohydrate, fat, protein and all, it is complex food. So it want to be converted into simple food. So what happened? The carbohydrate finally convert as a what? Glucose, galactose, in fructose. So like simple molecules. It is monosaccharides. But here the carbohydrate, that means starch, is polysaccharides. So polysaccharides convert as a monosaccharides. That monosaccharides absorbed by what? Our small intestine. Then it is sent it through blood link to the tissues. Okay. The next one, protein convert into amino acids. Then fat convert into what? Fatty acid and glycerol. Then nucleic acid convert into sugar plus bases. It is absorbed by our small intestine. Then it is sent to our tissues. Okay. Then tissues utilize that simple molecules and produce energy. So that utilization of nutrients is known as assimilation. I told that. Sir, here I want to ask one question. Sir, how our body is known? The secretion of that, when we need to secrete the enzymes, how our body is doing that, mean it is stimulated by hormones and neurons, that mean neural control and hormonal control. So several activities in intestinal tract, we have several activities. By that, digestion is happening, you know, I think. Then food also move step by step for digestion. It is done by what? Several activities. That activity is controlled by nervous and next one hormones. Okay, that is neural control and another one hormonal control. So example, salivary glands, you can take. When you look at the food, when you see the food, what happens? Automatically our mouth will be secrete what? Saliva. Okay, because of what? The sight is absorbed by what? Our eyes. Then it sends the message to the brain. Then automatically what happens? The salivary gland which secrete the saliva to digest the food. So when you taste the food, then what happens? That receptors present in tongue. Okay, that is gustatory receptors. That gustatory receptors which send the message to the brain, then the saliva will be secreted. So by the sight, by the smell, by the taste, it can stimulate it. Which one is? The salivary gland will be stimulated. Okay, so our enzymes will be secreted, then the food will be digested. So all the activities in the intestinal tract, it is done by the neural control and hormonal control. Okay, today we are going to see, I hope you all understood that digestion of food. If you have any doubt, you can contact me and get clarification. You don't worry. And next one, today we are going to see absorption of food. So as we said before, the small intestine doing the digestion process. What about large intestine? In last class I told that large intestine which consists waste products, that means waste material. Actually undigested food, unabsorbed food, it is sent to large intestine, from the small intestine to large intestine through the ileocecal valve. I told that through the ileocecal valve, the undigested food material which is entered into the cecum, then cecum to colon, then colon to rectum, then through the anus, the feces, that means the waste material which will be released. Actually, these all the things also controlled by neurons and next one hormones, that means nerves and hormones. So next is what? Absorption of food. So today we are going to see what? Absorption of food. It is the part of digestion and absorption chapter. So absorption, where does it happen? That means in small intestine. In mouth also absorption is happening, in stomach also absorption is happening, small intestine as well as large intestine also absorption is happening. Later I will tell you, because first we will see the small intestine, because major absorption is happening in small intestine. Okay, so in small intestine, where does it take place? That means in intestinal mucosa. Intestinal mucosa. Okay, from the intestinal mucosa, because you know, I think in alimentary canal we have four layers. In the wall of alimentary canal we have four layers. In the histology of gut, I told you. So last layer is what? Mucosa. So there the absorption is happened. Intestinal mucosa, which consists what? villi. You know, I think in the villi we have what? Blood capillaries and lymph. Actually, lymph vessel here it is called as lacti. Okay, lacti. The lymph vessel which is surrounded by blood, so it is called as lacti. Okay, through that absorption is happening. Then blood and lymph carrying the food materials, the main nutrients, the end product. Then it is reached to tissues. Then it is utilized. So absorption of food happened like this. So here, how it is absorbed? That means by two ways. One is passive transport. Transport. Next one, active transport. Passive transport and another one is active transport. Passive transport done by simple diffusion. Simple diffusion. Okay, so you know, I think diffusion, that means the molecules which is moved from lower concentration to higher concentration. So it is in the concentration of gradient. Okay, so the based on the concentration, the absorption is happening. Because you know, in plants, the root, how it is absorbed the water? By the process of osmosis. Okay, so the soil which consists more water droplets, water molecules, but in plant we have less water molecules, so the molecules, what it is happening, moving higher concentration to lower concentration, so it is absorbed. Okay, so likewise here, by the simple diffusion, the the end product of nutrients is what? Carbohydrate end product is glucose, then amino acids, some electrolytes. These are all the things. Little glucose, little amino acid, then amino acids, then electrolytes, which is absorbed by the small intestine in the passive transport by the simple diffusion. Okay, in active transport it needs energy, because to the higher gradient it want to be sent, so it need energy. So the nutrients want to send to the concentration gradient, so it need energy. But here in the passive transport it is not like that. It is lower concentration gradient will be there. So from the higher concentration to lower concentration it will move easy. But here it needs some energy to move to the concentration gradient. Okay, so right. So in the active transport it need what? Energy. So what it is happen in the with the help of energy, it is absorb glucose, it absorb most of the glucose and amino acids, glucose acids, which will be absorbed by the energy. Here the carrier is some proteins, carrier protein will be there. So that with help of carrier protein, the glucose, most of the glucose and amino acids, what it has happened? It is absorbed by the small intestine. Okay. So it move the nutrients against the concentration gradient. So it need energy. It with help of carrier protein, it is absorbed. So this like absorption is happening small intestine. Okay, the next one, what about fatty acid and glycerol? Because here we said glucose, amino acids and electrolytes. can't say about fatty acid and glycerol because fatty acid and glycerol is the end product of fat. But glucose, amino acid, end product of protein. Glucose is end product of starch unit, right? So how that will be observed? That means actually fatty acid plus glycerol, it is absorbed by actually first what is happened, the fatty acid and glycerol incorporate with each other, incorporate into the small fat droplets, that is micelles. So the fatty acid and glycerol, which is turned over into what? Small fat droplets, that is called as micelles or micelles. Then what has happened? It is reformed. It is reformed with small protein. Reformed with small protein coat. So then it is actually reformed with small protein coat in the fat globules. Okay. So that micelles or micelles, which is reformed with a small coating, that small coating coated with what? Fat globules. That fat droplets, here I have written like fat globules. That globules coated with protein. So that is called as chylomicrons. That chylomicrons absorbed by lactase. Okay. So fatty acid, glycerol turn into the bean, incorporate into micelles. And next one, it is that is fat droplets or fat globules that coated with protein, that it is called as chylomicrons. That chylomicrons absorbed by lactase. Lactase already I had explained that it is limp acid we have. Now once again I want to recall that. So in the real life that we have one limp vessel. That limp vessel, okay, so surrounded by what? Blood capillaries. Blood capillaries. Blood capillaries. Okay, so that blood capillaries and the lymph vessel. The lymph vessel is called as lactate. Lactate. So the lactate absorbs what? Chylomicrons. Then it is goes to lymph. Okay, it is carried out by lymph. Which one? Chylomicrons. Then next it is sent to blood because the lymph, which is collecting the useful materials from the cells, we have some useful materials which is comes out from the blood vessels. That it is drying out by what? Lymph. Actually, it is act as a small drainage system. Which one? Lymph, which is collecting all the useful material again drying into blood. Then only we have constant RBC, WBC, plasma. Okay, right. So the blood carried out what? The fat and the glycerol in product. So the fatty acid glycerol is in product. So that is carried out by blood. By these are all the processes happen, then only it is absorbed, because directly the fatty acid and glycerol cannot absorb by our small intestine. blood, then it goes to where? Tissues, then it is utilized. So it is what? Absorption of food in the small intestine. It is absorption of food in the small intestine. So after digestion, the absorption is very very important process. Okay, without absorption we cannot get the food materials for our tissues. Then if our tissues cannot receive the food materials, that means we cannot get the energy, so we could not lose many organs. Okay, so the digestion also important, then as well as absorption also important. Now we are in the edge of chapter 16. The final topic is some disorders happen in the digestive system. Okay, so in next topic we are going to see disorder of digestive system. So now we have seen absorption of food in the small intestine, and before that I told in the starting of absorption of food, I told that absorption is happen in small intestine as well as in the mouth, in the stomach, even in the large intestine. In mouth that we have mucosa. So that mucosa also absorbs some certain drugs. So some certain drugs which is contacted with the mucosa, so it is absorbed with which one? Mouth. Okay, then just below the tongue also absorption is happening. So just below of the tongue and in the mucosa the absorption is happening. So certain drugs will be absorbed in the mouth. The next one, stomach. Stomach which is absorbed water, alcohol. It is absorbed by the water and alcohol is absorbed by the stomach. Then small intestine, small intestine which is absorbed all the nutrients, that means the end product of nutrients, the carbohydrate end product is glucose, galactose, fructose, that is absorbed by the small intestine. Then fatty acid, glycerol, then amino acid, then fatty acid, glycerol, it is absorbed by the small intestine. Glycerol. Then next, glucose. So amino acid, fatty acid, glycerol, glucose, which is absorbed by the small intestine. And large intestine. Large intestine mainly absorb the water. Then certain drugs also. Certain drugs which is absorbed in the large intestine. So absorption is happening all the area. Then some minerals also absorbed in the large intestine. So the absorption is happening mouth, stomach, small intestine and large intestine. Okay, then after absorbing these things, the waste material will be released. So waste material will be released through the anus, that means that is called as defecation. So through the anus, waste material will be released, that is called as defecation. It is also controlled by nerves. Okay, that that is voluntary actions. Okay, right. So next we are going to see disorder of digestive system. Disorders of digestive system. It is the last topic in this chapter. Disorders of digestive system. So first disorder is inflammation. Inflammation of intestinal tract. Inflammation of intestinal tract. So here the inflammation is happened by bacteria or virus. Sometimes the infection happened by parasites also. Parasites. What are all the parasites involved in this disorder? The main roundworm, pinworm, hookworm, then tapeworm. So the roundworm, pinworm, hookworm, tapeworm, some bacteria, some virus also, which cause what? Inflammation in the intestinal tract. It is one disorder. The knee swelling is happen, and some hot feeling which will be happen inside the intestinal tract. Okay, in Tamil we can say that so that inflammation of intestinal tract. Okay, the next one, second one, is jaundice is one of the disorder due to the bile pigments. What it is happen? That mean the eyes, skin and eyes, which is turned into yellow color. So skin and eyes will be turned into yellow color due to the bile pigment level is increased. It is what? Jaundice. Okay, the next one, third one, vomiting. Third one is what? Vomiting. It is ejection of stomach content. Ejection of stomach content through the mouth. Then it is one of the reflex action. It is controlled by medulla. It is controlled by what? Medulla. Medulla, it is what? It is one part of the brain, vomiting medulla, which control the vomiting sensation. Before vomiting, we have one feeling, it is called as nausea. Nausea precedes of precedes of vomit. Okay, it is nausea is precedes of vomiting, because vomit comes before the nausea is happen. Nausea is one of the vomiting feeling, right? So this is what disorders of digestive system. First one is inflammation of intestinal tract. The next one jaundice, because liver is combined with our digestive system. So that's why jaundice is undercoming the disorder of digestive system. So then vomiting. Vomiting, which is ejection of stomach content. Okay, if food poison has happened. Okay, so, some disease causing microorganism food is present. That means, or overeating, what it is done? Vomiting will come. The next one, fourth one, diarrhea. Fourth one is what? Diarrhea. Diarrhea is abnormal frequency of bowel movement. It releases liquidity of fecal matter. So abnormal frequency of bowel movement. Here the bowel, which denote small intestine and large intestine. So the abnormal of bowel movement, which cause what? Diarrhea. And apart from that, food poisoning also, which cause diarrhea. Then you know, I think amoebic dysentery also happen because of amoeba, right? So due to the some microorganisms, due to the food poisoning, which is which one? Diarrhea. What it is happen? That means liquidity of fecal matter. So our waste material, you know, I think it is in solidifying. That means it is solid in nature. Okay. So, but here in the diarrhea, it is the waste material goes as a liquid. So that is what diarrhea. The next one, fifth one is constipation. Next one is constipation. Constipation, that means the fecal matter which we cannot release properly. So it is retained in the large intestine. That means in cecum and colon and rectum, which is stored, that means retained. So that is constipation. Because of inadequate water, then roughage, you know, that content present in some leafy vegetables. Okay, so if we have so much of water content, as well as the roughage which is present in the leafy vegetables, that means the constipation will not happen. So constipation, that means the feces are retained due to the bowel movement occur irregularly. So due to the bowel movement, the bowel movement occur irregularly. So the constipation is happening. If it is happened regularly, that means the constipation will not happen. The waste material automatically will be released. Okay, then sixth one, indigestion. It is indigestion means, you know, I think the digestion will not happen properly because of overeating, and because of spicy food, and because of food poison. Something is reason for indigestion. Okay, so indigestion happened by food poison, overeating, then spicy food like that. Then it is actually sometimes happened by inadequate enzymes production that secretes. So if enzymes will not secrete properly, inadequately it will be secreted, that means indigestion has happened. So these all the things which comes under disorders of digestive system. I hope you all understood that inflammation of intestinal tract and jaundice, vomiting, then diarrhea and constipation, then indigestion. So now we have completed the chapter 16, the digestion and absorption chapter 9. So here in chapter 16 we have 6 part. This is the part 6. Here before we have completed 5 parts. So you have to check in a Google Classroom. So part 1, part 2, part 3, part 4, part 5, part 6. This is the last one, part 6. So now we have completed digestion and absorption. So overall view of chapter 16, that means digestion and absorption, that means from the beginning we have seen what is digestion, and in the digestive system what are all the parts will be there. Then structure of digestive system, there we have mouth, buccal cavity, then pharynx, epiglottis, we have which cut the windpipe, then next one esophagus, stomach, then small intestine, large intestine, small intestine further divided into 3 types. One is duodenum, jejunum, and ileum. Then large intestine is cecum, colon, and rectum. Finally, it is open through the anus. So, the structure of digestive system, what are the organs are present in the digestive system, we have seen. And next, what are the glands present in the digestive system? Salivary glands, then liver, pancreas, we have seen that diagram also, I drew that. Okay, right. Then histology of gut, that we have 4 layers, one is serosa, then muscularis, then submucosa, then mucosa. Finally, the mucosa which consists villi. In villi we have lactate which surrounded by the blood capillaries, you know, I think. So then after that, digestion of food, how digestion happen in the mouth, how digestion happen in the stomach, how digestion happen in the small intestine, what is the role of enzymes, pancreatic juice and intestinal juice and bile juice, what are the role of these things we have seen. I hope you all understood that. Then next, finally, absorption of food, we have seen in the today class we have seen absorption of food and disorders of digestive system. Okay, so go through all videos in this chapter, that means part 1, part 2, part 3, part 4, part 5, part 6, that all the videos you have to go through that, and take your book, that means NCERT book, and go through that, read well. If you have any doubt, I am ready to clarify your doubt, so don't worry. I hope you all understood that. Thank you very much.